Hello and welcome everybody, I'm Proper Varian, and welcome back here to Crusader Kings 3, where we are looking at an episode I think that could change the fate of not just Northern Iberia, but also our Roman Empire. We're looking at a challenge, we're looking at a bit of a struggle here that could indeed question not just Christian supremacy over Santiago, which is one of our most important holy sites and a path that we have sworn to protect, but also the supremacy of the unified and recreated Western Roman Empire. If we were to fail in this war, if we do not succeed to show our authority and our protection that we can give to the people that deserve and desire it, if we fail to do that, then this could indeed be basically immediately the death knell of the Empire yet again. What do I mean with this? I mean that after a long time of infighting, the Umayyads and the Marwanids have finally gotten back together. You can see that they have a marriage alliance here. I believe it is his son and indeed the sister of the Malik of Al-Andalus that have now gotten together and that have convinced Malik Said II and Malik Yahya II that it is the time to challenge Galicia. And it comes at a very odd time. It comes at a time where we as Christians maybe have to admit that we underestimated and ignored the Christian, or rather the non-Christian world, for far too much. What I mean is that we are here, we are essentially on a minor campaign, we just have a small rebellion, it is basically a family conflict where Infante Muñoz Sabellé is indeed rebelling against King García Sabellé, and we said to ourselves, this is a brother conflict, but we need peace in Santiago. So we showed up with a fairly minor force, and then it turns out that this isn't what is actually happening. Our campaign in Galicia is being used by the Umayyads and the Marwanids to directly challenge whether we can protect both the Empire, Santiago, but I think also ourselves. They have grown bold, and if we don't answer now, then I mean, who can really listen to an emperor that can't even protect a holy site that is oh so important to him? So, all in all, this war that appears fairly minor, look at it, you know, they just declared war here for Porto itself, but this war is a challenge. The Muslims are saying we recognize the threat of a resurgent Western Roman Empire. Whether they believe that it is the Western Roman Empire or not doesn't really matter. What they need is to break the spell. They need to destroy the Emperor and the Empire that could become a long-term threat. Because, quite frankly, right now, we are superior in numbers, at least in this war. You know, when you look at this, 21,000 against 17,000, but the Muslims have a fighting chance. And I don't just mean this to basically build them up, you know, I'm not sandbagging here. What I'm saying is that they have a formidable force. Look at this. Look at our forces first. We, you know, got some light footmen, some horsemen, some pikemen, and then some onagas, and that is it. But look at them. 1,300 caballeros, 500 pikemen, 700 armored footmen. This is the moment in history, I think, where the Muslims have a very good shot at defeating us. Now, before we jump into this, I just want to say that CyberXCan, the creator of the Rice mod, actually was so nice that he prepared a version of the newly released update that is compatible with my save game and contains so much content that we surely will be using. You can see we got some interactions here with the Way of St. James, we can compose a cantiga now, and of course we could also even compile the Cantigas de Santa Maria. Again, I don't actually know how to pronounce it, but this is super cool and I am looking forward to engaging with this. Just thought you should know, and I think I can just build up from this and say that I keep getting questions, and I understand it, that are basically asking, can you just put everything you're using into a mod list and let us know? And the answer really is a no, because this is basically a dead save walking. It comes from 1.5 point whatever the hell it was. I modified the save game, I modified the mods, I backed them all up, I configured them differently, I adapted them to the situation that, you know, we are in here in this save game. So many of the mods that I'm using, for example, this one, largely works because of the very specific situation that we have in this save game. There really isn't a valid mod list I could give you, and there can't be one. Whenever this playthrough ends and we jump into a new one, I am sure that we, you know, then we'll actually have a mod list that I can hand out. So, with all that being said, as we are campaigning in Galicia, I think it is time to consider bringing our full forces. I thought about this as well. Historically speaking, of course, you could argue that this is our campaigning force, that we committed to this campaign, and the rest, you know, our other vassals, we didn't actually call upon, we didn't ask them to provide their troops, but I have to tell you right now, that is sadly not how CK3 works. I would love to do it, even if it means losing, but since they will always come with a full force of their troops, I think it would just be rather irrational and kind of stupid if we didn't do it. I hope that eventually we might be looking at a different warfare system, but that day is not now. The other thing that we are going to do is we are going to ask the Pope for money. I screened the situation, I checked the Holy Order. A, we can't hire them anyway. It's way too much piety that we would need. Man, these are some good Order Knights, though. I would really like to have the Knights Templar on board. But sadly, Grandmaster Onchumak Dublemna of the Knights Templar is busy, and I think we can actually find out where they are. Where are you? He is in Segni. So, is that true? I mean, they are hired, so surely they are in somebody's possession. I can't tell you who it is, but it doesn't really matter because we couldn't hire them anyway. I did check Alicia as well. He is in no position to actually hire them either. We could hope that Leon Go does it if they become free in time, but I gotta be honest with you, unless I have them in my possession, I am unsure whether King Martin VS would actually use them properly. This campaign is a very, very important one. I will ask the Pope for money, as I said. I will use our piety for this. And then we're going to recruit some mercenaries, I suppose, and I can only hope that we will actually get this under control. I've considered your plight and decided to grant your request. These funds will bring me victory. Pope Stephanus has been too good to us. He has been a true friend of us, our best friend, quite literally, but also just a good friend of Western Christianity. I really wish we could repay him here by actually moving in against the Eastern Roman Empire, but of course we are preoccupied. I think we really need to dish it out here. Maybe the Great Catalan Company. Who are the other competitors here? You know what? No. I think... How many do we get here? 354. We largely care about the pikemen. I desperately, desperately, desperately need to counter the caballeros. If I can do that, maybe we have a chance. I don't really care for the levies. I don't really care for what else, you know, for example, the Gasconiera band or the Galician band. I don't really care for what else they have to offer to begin with. I think we're going to choose just the cheapest spearmen right here so that we can finance this war just a bit longer. This will give us 354, which is the same amount as the more expensive ones, except, of course, fewer levies and no other type. I think this will be fine. These knights are okay as well. I mean, he's a terrible knight. Jesus, I mean, he's 62. Yeah, fair enough. Let's hire them and let's try to make this work. Again, not many troops, but it's really more about the count. And you know what? We never do this, but I do think we need to study something here because... the differences when it comes to the terrain where you are fighting are not born equally. What I mean is that, for example, obviously, ideally, we would like to fight them in wetlands. I mean, horses do very, very poorly there. But the difference here is, for example, you know, we don't really have desert mountains. We really need the mountains. If we fight in hills, if we fight in plains, or if we fight in the dry lands, look at that. It's devastating. We really do not want to be fighting them in the hills, I think, ultimately. Mountains would be ideal, maybe the plains otherwise, but... Yeah, the caballeros simply excel in the hills of Iberia. And with that, of course, we now need to consider where we will actually fight. I will try to hide out here in the mountains. We'll split this army. And whenever it will come to a fight, I want to make this clear as well. I will put Emperor Philippe the Great in. He is a warrior. He is somebody that is a blade master. He's a holy warrior. He will be leading that army that will be facing the enemy first and foremost. It has to be done. And hopefully we will indeed be getting it done. I don't think there's much else that I can do here, except I suppose I need to assign a guardian for you. Who's your father? Prince Alvar. And there was a good question as well. Shouldn't we give Prince Alvar maybe some land? I don't necessarily disagree. Wait, where is Alvar? It's just that it does some wacky things with inheritance. I wish I could pretty simply do it, right? But I don't really see that in the cards right now. Aurea, you will be brought up by your mother. I think that is perfectly reasonable. We got some low durability artifacts. We can take care of that later. Yeah, all of these I think we can... We don't have to worry about right now. I think we will be okay. Yeah, let's see where this goes. I am quite afraid, I will admit. Yeah, and there they come. The armies of Al-Andalus and Batallias are indeed here in this mountain pass. I really wonder what this is called. Gredo, I suppose. I don't know. These are, of course, the troops that stem from this wall right here. I am not sure. Honestly, I might just go right here so that we can siege this and actually end this war, and then we will go from there. All of these troops need to come over here indeed. Just make sure that you're marching faction against me. Franconian Catholic populists. Excuse me. Franconian Catholic populists. We have Franconians in our realm. Mets. Oh. That is kind of funny. Huh. I honestly didn't realize that we reached this far into the east, but that is, I mean, we are, again, Western Roman Empire, how else could it be? Yeah, so what I'm saying is, this is such a tight war because they have truly elite men-at-arms. We have to challenge them in the right moment or we may get wiped, even if we are numerically superior. Those caballeros, man. Those damn caballeros. Now, where are they going here? This siege is progressing quite nicely, but I am worried that they might catch me off guard here. Why are you going? No, no, no. Don't go in there. I didn't... Oh, it's the Leonese that... Really? I mean, come on. You know, it's a classic AI blunders. Let's hope that it doesn't bite us in the behind, but I think they are blundering here. Oh, we need to get our troops together, no doubt. There's really only one way where they can go, and it's thematically, it's just so nice. Obviously, they aren't actually threatening Santiago right now, but I believe that they have seen the strong fortifications that we have raised in no time whatsoever here in the mountains, and they've decided that we left Santiago undefended. If we strike them down in Santiago now, that would be cinematic. Yeah, wow. With the, if they actually get the boat penalty, we could benefit very, very, like, in a major way here. Let's just hope that we can actually get them to commit to this. Indeed, they have committed, so they will be eating the penalty. This siege will be done in just a second. And then we can continue onwards from there. Where are you going? What are you doing, my friend? Is this the AI maybe behaving suboptimally? Could they have attacked me here? Yeah, but, you know, campaign mishaps, as much as they are micro mishaps, which is just basically the AI being kind of bad sometimes. Campaign mishaps happen, and since we don't have a better depiction of campaigns than this, I'm gonna take it. You know, I'm not gonna just accept what they're doing and not respond to it. So we've sieged down these lands. If we get them to land in Santiago, I mean, my god, that would be incredible. Just genuinely incredible. Maybe they will actually land in the capital. That seems quite likely, doesn't it? Yeah, well, I will try to make my way up there, maybe undetected, so that they actually commit to it. Oh, they're immediately coming back. Oh, you buffoons. Okay, everybody right here. I will fight you in the plains if it means that you are on the penalty here. And indeed, you are on the penalty. I will come in first with the king or with the emperor, as I declared previously. It will happen. It must happen. And the emperor will indeed be present. Will this be successful? Because they are, of course, going to land with a bunch of people that previously weren't there. Wait a minute. Who just died? Oh, Veronica died. Died of natural causes. And with that, Duke Philippe, Veronique, actually has taken over. And somebody pointed out, by the way, that they annexed the land today. No, no. Count Mechipsa is still here. He's doing well. He's just a vassal. I didn't notice that initially either, but he was a baron. And when I gave him the land, he remained a vassal of Veronica, which is why she now has a vassalage of those areas. Duke Philippe Veronique is not a powerful vassal. Veronica always fought for a position on the council, it has to be said. And I do love Duke Philippe. He's my grandson. And what an honorable man he is, named after myself, I can only assume. But I think we really do have, we have a French representation, we do have some Italian representation, then Transuranian. Honestly, I can see Duke Bertrand, don't get me wrong here. But I think, you're not getting on the council. I think seeing Aquitania come in here, just an Aquitanian vassal, might be a good idea. No, you know what, actually I'm being foolish. Duke Suleiman. Yes, he is not the person that, you know, deserves a title on the council, but he is campaigning with us. He swore fealty and he recognized the threat of the Muslims. If there's anybody in my ear when it comes to military matters, it is Duke Suleiman, even if others, of course, you know, deserve maybe to be on the council as well. I need to build up Mazana. I don't know why you are so down in control, but it doesn't really matter. Yeah, Duke Suleiman is a trusted advisor right now. He is our military right hand in this campaign. Let's hope that he's advising us wisely. But this is it. This is the engagement. And oh my god. Yeah, this is the engagement. We catch them in the right moment, but with very few troops. And oh no. I mean, this is a great catch. Don't get me wrong here. This war has ended. What do I get from this? I'm not sure. It doesn't actually matter. We caught Malik Yahya II Ibn Yahya off guard. And this is vital. This is actually him commanding these troops. If we could capture him here in the Battle of Porto, it would be a genuinely magnificent victory. And man, we caught 500 caballeros here. We can wipe out a good section of their troops indeed. I need to take a look at this. Yeah, we arrived fairly late to... We actually wiped them? Oh my god, we wiped them. We didn't capture him, mind you, but we actually wiped them. Those caballeros are off the menu. Wow, 600 caballeros gone. That is actually massive. He is going for... What are you... Come on, man. What are you thinking? He is going for ally. But I don't think... I mean, unless we arrive there in time, I don't think that we can really catch him off guard. Yeah, we might fight him here in the mountains, but... We can't actually aid him. They're too far away. He's too splintered. Oh, and he stopped marching, didn't he? Isn't that interesting? I think we have the enemies where we want them as well. And here we have Duke Suleiman, by the way, which is why I love for him to be around. I don't want to fight them in the hills. I'm sorry to tell you this. I'm unwilling to fight them in the hills. I think it would be a terrible idea. As long as we defend our position here, we'd be good. Isn't that crazy? He's currently not doing anything. Who did we capture anyway? We captured... I'm not actually certain. There they are. Valiv Vladimir of Olivienza. Ah, a friend of our other mayor, I would assume. Mayor Malusha. And by the way, I thought I had told her to become Catholic. I'm going to do it now without a doubt. If only for this war. You can't be Mualadi. You can't still be a part of the Muslim creed. Things are heating up. The acceptance that we had previously, you know, the tolerance that we had, is clearly gone. Now he's going down to Abero. I will simply keep my units, you know, as they are, as a fairly solid unit. Although I do need to split you here. Move you right there, I suppose. And there you go. She has converted. All right. Mayor Malusha, I appreciate that. I genuinely appreciate that. And obviously we're not going to be holding court. I mean, come on. Ridiculous. Now, the positive news here really is that they are slowly but surely running out of supplies. And when that happens, we will actually have the upper hand. I actually think that this is one of the more fun wars, and I think we can make something happen here. Count Gosfried has turned Cisalpine. I'm at peace with this. I think that is entirely up to them. We speak French, of course, but... You know, even then, what is this? Vassals attack each other. Defending. It is a tyranny war. Okay, some local wars. I'm not happy, of course, with Duchess Violon, but... Yeah, I do think we are quite busy. And oh god. It is an important moment. I have prowled through documents, both ancient and of less certain provenance. I finally have enough material to make the case that you are the rightful lord of the Prince Bishopric of Ravenna. Seeing as Lambert unfortunately insists on being orthodox, I could even argue that you have a claim to the Duchy of Romagna by divine right. Yes. I will pay this money because this is something that we shouldn't forget. Emperor Philippe the Great has to get the protection of the Pope done. Kicking out the Exarch of Ravenna is the most important part of this. Pancratios right here. I will claim it. Let's hope that it doesn't make us go bankrupt, of course. Couldn't imprison criminals. I don't think we need to. Witchcraft induction. Santa Elizabeth's secret. I assume it's because of Elizabeth herself. Yeah, we do know that she's a witch. There are, and this is why I was so okay with giving up witchcraft, there are parts of this family that very much still adhere to witchcraft. I mean, both of our children do, except Nuno. I think it is perfectly fine. It's a wing that we have largely ignored because it didn't really interfere with the work of the good Christians here. Oh, and Prince Alva has consumption. We do need a physician. We will take care of Prince Alva. And by the way, I'm attempting here to potentially strike them down where they stand. They are undersupplied by now. But we're not going to catch them, are we? They are splintering. They are splintering, aren't they? Court physician, right? I can't hire Oneka. Listen, we're a person that cares. But we know that warfare needs money. I will hire Endulkia rather than Oneka here, just because, oh man, but Oneka is really good. I would definitely trust her there, and I trust her much, much more than I trust Endulkia, but we do risk going bankrupt. I'll hire her, yeah. Man, that's a bad decision, but it's a decision that I feel is in character. We hired a person that can actually heal our son quite possibly, and a person that Emperor Philippe the Great genuinely respects, which... I do think plays a big role in how he makes hiring decisions. And they are going... Oh, interesting. Could we catch them? I think we simply want to catch them here. Quite frankly, let's just go into battle. I need to kick out myself from right here. I will take them. We'll resign this commander. And then I will put myself on it, of course. I will remove this commander as well. It still looks like we're winning. I'm going in. Yeah. I think we can do this. Defending a river crossing, of course. But we are waging a bit of an aggressive campaign here as well. They are, of course, in a worse position as far as supplies are concerned. But man, yeah, not a good battle so far. Child of my dynasty, Carlos. I always knew it would be a risky battle. I just trusted maybe the battle foretelling there a bit too much. But it's going to be a close one. It's going to be a very, very close one. And it looks like we actually have it. Oh my god. We showed bravery. I showed bravery by actually trusting that battle calculator. We showed bravery and we emerged victoriously. Enemy combatants captured. Let's just take a look at this. 1,400 prestige gained just from this battle. 50% Worska gained just from this battle. 736 piety. We took the war to them. We showed them that they shouldn't be messing around with the Emperor of the Romans. I am so proud of that battle, because that was a risk, and it was a stupid risk that if you really want to min-max the Viking, you shouldn't have taken, but this is a battle that Emperor Philippe the Great would have taken, rather than letting it, you know, them be abused by taking ship again. Don't worry about that. We did it. We succeeded on, basically on fair grounds, and we succeeded in a major, major way. Now, we do have Duke Suleiman, who is injured. He lost his leg here. That is a damn shame, and wait a minute, he has a son, but I'm his heir. He's a bastard. Duke Suleiman. His lands are gonna fall to me, aren't they? I don't know what I would be doing with those lands, I have to admit. But yeah, look at that. What a major battle. And how come that you, a Behar, a member of the Northern Dynasty, is serving on the enemy's... Wow. In the enemy's army. We wounded many, many of theirs. I mean, just look at this. Beautiful. Emir Ali ibn Aliyah, who is, of course, the Lord of Tuliatula, has been wounded. Abdul Hassan has been wounded. A direct son, actually. We killed the son. We killed his primary heir. This battle should be a lesson to the Marwanids and, I think, to the world at large. We defended Santiago at the Battle of Abero, and I am absolutely in love with it. I think that is more than just gorgeous. Ah, we are now bankrupt. I don't like that. But that is absolutely beautiful. Can I sell anybody for like some real money here? No? Alright, I'll sell Wali Amir here. This war should be over if I'm not mistaken. Let's just start sieging here. It should end in due time. But yeah, I don't like being in debt and I can't dissolve my troops. Either way, let's continue. And there it is. So we are actually in the positive, by the way. I sold some prisoners and then we occupied Abero, which of course gives us money. And this occupation seals the deal. Oh my god, it is very, very positive. It is so nice to actually see this victory right here. Let me check something here, right? What would I be getting? How much did I contribute to this war? It doesn't tell me there, does it? Oh, there we are. War contribution, 74%. He has 25%. I mean, honestly, quite honorable by King Martin VS of Leongo. I admire that. He served quite well where he needed to serve, and I think in a way, and I talked about this elsewhere as well, the Holy Roman Empire, for example, when it comes to Bohemia, when it comes to Poland, they had a very light but nonetheless hierarchy relationship with Poland, where the Polish kings had to appear when the Holy Roman Empire would summon them, where the Polish king's church structure was indeed dependent on the emperor's church structure. And I think we have a very similar situation with this, with us actually taking part in this campaign, waging the war and succeeding, being victorious. I think it is fair to say that we have a soft suzerain slash tributary relationship with Leongo and Galicia. Navarra and Castella, maybe not so much. Difficult to see, but we have been a good overlord. We, after all, succeeded in waging this war, in bringing peace for Santiago, in securing it as one of the most important pilgrimage sites that can possibly exist. The war has ended. Let's take a look at this. I have gained 108 prestige. You love to see it. They paid money to King Garcia. I love to see that even more. I wonder whether we can become a living legend. I doubt it, but at least the Paragon of Virtue should be viable. For the moment, you know what? At the last stages here of this episode, what do you want to do? A chest? No, I'm not interested about any of these. I will be holding court. Of course I will be holding court. I return home after the trials and tribulations and I find an empire that is still loyal to me, that hasn't acted against me in any way whatsoever. And I say, of course, I will grant audience to any of the ills that may have befallen my vassals. Let's take care of it. So who do we have here?
Ooh, Duke Suleiman. I'm very interested in this. Duke Suleiman, that might be an interested one. Count Benoit of Beruga. I don't think we ever interacted, but this is a very interesting petition right here, because he's native Frankish. He is actually one of our most distant vassals, I would say, and then Duke François Mathey of Friuli. Now, he is important because he is the son of one of our good friends, Duke Mathey the Monster. Let's take a look. My vassal Duke François takes a turn bending my ear before the assembled court. Glorious liege, give me the honor of organizing the royal hunts and protecting the game. I will not let you down. I suppose these jobs have to be done by somebody. I want to quickly take a look here. Istria, I believe, yes. Duke Bertrand is the most important of the sons of Mathey. Duke François wants recognition. He actually turned Gasconiere. My god. Was he always Gasconiere? And then right here we have Duke Gilbert of Ferrone. All three of which are important vassals of the realm. And all three of which are actually quite happy. He got fired. Right, I assume he got fired because, Ah, oh, that sucks so much. He has the negative opinion because I destroyed the kingdom via the decision, right? I mean, what are you gonna do about it, right? Duke Gilbert of Ferrone. I'm not gonna demand anything. I have a lot of goodwill for these three. I will make him the master of the hunt. And Duke Bertrand, I mean, you are an excellent, excellent martial leader and an excellent fighter. I might not give you a council position, but I might give you an honorable position as well. I might see this as a bit of a brother petition right here. What are the other options? We have need of other talents? No. I think if he comes here to be the master of the hunt, then he shall be the master of the hunt. My vassal Count Benoit approaches me, smiling with cold intent like he often does. My lord, I have a brilliant idea. How about we host a fair, or perhaps even a festival of the common folk to expose them to one of the different cultures in our beautiful kingdom? Benoit explains his idea further, until he realizes that he is dangerously close to over-explaining it. It'll cost money, but I'm sure it will help foster a more positive relationship between our people. That's a lot of money. I will... Because I'm humble. I just don't have the money for this, Count Benoit. I think that we would gladly do this. I want to work together, and let me actually check this. How many... We have a single Neder-Frankish province in our realm. I am absolutely of the opinion that Emperor Philippe the Great is a person that would love to host such a thing. He would love to show up, essentially, and say, of course, we should love one another. We are together in this as Christians. But I have to tell you that Emperor Philippe, he isn't, you know, somebody that spends his money just because he can, and he is certainly a person that is also very humble. The way I see this is, we're not going to take this decision. I sadly, and I want to earmark this, basically, to Count Benoit, that maybe we're not as good an emperor for the distant corners of our realm as we would like to be, but Count Benoit will definitely be disappointed here. This has to be earmarked. Some cultures, some regions of the empire are clearly neglected by the emperor because we just don't have the potential. We don't have the resources to do it. We are at the capacity of our administrative abilities, and we won't overspend, because that is not who Emperor Philippe is. He isn't greedy, but he isn't profligate either. I cannot spend resources on this. We still have an open fight with the Eastern Roman Empire, after all. Duke Suleiman of Valencia. Now, I am very ecstatic about this. What is this? Duke Suleiman, my vassal, strides forward, clearly eager to hear my response to his petition. My liege, Valencia trade is stifled by a lack of currency. That is my lead. Establish our own mints with royal approval for the good of the Aromator Imperius Santur. Ismailid, he is asking for his house to receive this privilege. Do not stymie the potential prosperity of your subjects, and we may all grow rich together. Very interesting. He is greedy, of course. I can see why he thinks the way that he does. No, I don't really care for the borders here. Right now, and I think that Emperor Philippe is very aware of this, Suleiman isn't even going to inherit this land to anybody. It will fall back to the crown as it stands, and with that in mind, I'm not really against letting him mint his coins, but I will change something. I will get a weak hook on him, so that is absolutely perfect. We're going to do this, and now I have to ask whether I can actually go and change his contract again. Modify vassal contract, because I can't do it. I really would have needed him to become a march. I'm going to do it with him either way, with Duke Arar right here. I understand. Valencia, basically, Duke Suleiman is saying he has seen so much war in his lifetime, and he surely knew that I would want him to be a march, to always serve in the army, to always bring the men of Valencia and fight with us. And he's rejecting this. He's essentially saying, we need more trade. We need to secure the Western Mediterranean so that our people can survive. And I recognize that. I mean, it is a wise move on his part, I suppose. But of course, I'm going to at least move Aragon into this now. He has 8 troops. It doesn't really matter. It is about the Duchy of Aragon as a whole, I think. Interesting petition coming from Duke Suleiman for sure. I think he knows that our emperor was ready to gear the entirety of Iberia under our control towards being marches, towards fighting the Muslims whenever necessary. And he said, my lord, you don't necessarily understand what is happening here. The situation in Iberia is complex. Yes, they wanted to challenge your authority, but we can't be exclusively fighting our enemies, the Muslims, because sometimes we must work together. Sometimes there is more than just faith that plays a role in these lands. And even though we may not fully understand Iberian politics, I do think we understand what he's asking from us. And quite frankly, see, I might actually push him out here. I'm going to leave him as the marshal right now. But it's an interesting predicament. I don't think he wants to be a marshal. I think he wants to simply enjoy what he has and what he has built. And speaking of that, I want to give a position. I might want to give the royal architect position, actually. Do we have anybody here that is good? Champagne? Because we are... Okay, I'm going to hand this out to Champagne so that I can bind him to my court. He's French, so quite distant, and he's excellent at it. I'm going to give this to him. And then I would like to give a position to Duke Bertrand of Istria. Something that ideally he would be good at as well. Do we have something where he can fight Seneschal? I don't think that is his position. What about a body? No, bodyguards, right. I need a personal champion. Oh, they need to be unlanded, really. I could just make a master of the horse. It works quite well together with that, I think, as well. Duke Bertrand, I want you to know that that the crown still very much respects your position here. And with that, we have given out a couple more positions. You love to see it. He is bad at it, Jesus. Yeah, but he is great at it. He gets a good opinion bonus right here. The knight effectiveness goes up. In the next episode, I don't even think we're going to wage war against the ERA. I think we need to rebuild a little bit. And I think we might be looking towards these unique decisions that came with the update to the rice mod thanks to CyberXCan. I am very happy. I'm incredibly enthusiastic about the fact that we actively defended against the Marwanites and that we did it in such a brave way. It's difficult to show bravery with the way the microsystem works in CK3, but I think it is fair to say Emperor Philippe the Great has shown bravery. He made his way past Porto, he defeated them in their own land and let them know that they aren't even safe there. I think that is the exactly right message the Emperor had to send. This is the end of this episode, however, and I will see you in the next one. Later, alligator.